judíos y no simplemente matarlos, sino que venderlos por dineros.
And the Zionists, he needed a massive amount of money, so he went to the Zionist organizations.
Y necesitaba mucho dinero, así que fue a las organizaciones sionistas.
And they kept on pulling him along and said, sure, we'll give you money. But they didn't want to give him. In fact, they saw that his people, Rabbi Weissmandl's people, got arrested because they didn't want to save these Jews.
Y al final fueron arrestados porque la verdad es que no querían que estos judíos fueran salvados.
So a third of Slovakia and all Hungarian Jews, we can thank that they were murdered. A large part had to do because of the Zionist intervention.
Y bueno, podemos agradecer que por la intervención sionista, un tercio de la población de Eslovaquia fue asesinada.
Perfetti speaks about this story.
El libro Perfetti habla de esto.
And again, there's much more. India agreed. I'll finish. India agreed to take it. What? Yeah. Well, England was had one of the colonies was in India, and
una de las colonias estaba en India.
And again, it's in this book, and you can find it, I believe, in our site. I'm not sure the book called the Holocaust Victims Accused. That in the British Parliament had a meeting. 277 parliamentary signatories, it's a long thing, you can read about it, that Britain had arranged that the government of India was willing to take in all the Jews, not all the Jews, they were willing to take in the Jews who were able to leave.
India?
In India, yeah.
Existe un documento donde se dice que India estaba dispuesto a recibir a todos los judíos en sus tierras.
And they had a meeting in Parliament, the British Parliament, 277 parliamentary signatories.
Y tuvieron reuniones con el Parlamento Británico.
And the Zionists stood up and they said, what, to India? We want these Jews to come to Palestine.
Y los sionistas dijeron que no querían, que querían que se fueran a Palestina.
Why not Palestine? And they objected to letting the Jews go to India. And so the Parliament, it became nil. The vote became null and void. And therefore, Japan, again, I'm really going to finish it. Japan also offered to take
Japón
in the Jews.
También se ofreció a recibir a los judíos.
There's a document, it's called a documentary called Sugihara. It is a German diplomat who went out and put his neck out
un
to save the Jews.
Alemán.
In the documentary they write that Japan offered to take in all the Jews without any documentation.
Claro, y que Japón ofreció a recibir a todos los judíos sin ningún tipo de identificación.
And they approached Stephen Wise. Stephen Wise was a reform rabbi in New York who was a Zionist.
Y se aproximaron a un rabino sionista, Wise.
And he threw out the representatives of Japan. He threw them out of his office.
Y los echó de su oficina. Yeah. A los representantes de Japón.
It's mind-boggling. And they have the chutzpah, the audacity,
y
the nerve.
La audacia y el nervio
to accuse others.
De acusar a otros.
Of minimizing the Holocaust when their hands are covered in the blood of Jews from the Holocaust.
Cuando sus manos están cubiertas de sangre del Holocausto.
Yeah.
Just,
yeah.
Thanks.
Yeah.
Que contiene el Talmud. Y lo otro que interesa a Chile es que ciertos grupos hablan sobre el interés de los grupos sionistas en la Patagonia, con el llamado Plan Andina.
Okay. La pregunta de allá para hacer la pregunta.
Bien. Mira, mi pregunta tiene que ver con cómo ven ellos. La intifada, la segunda intifada, partió porque Ariel Sharon entra a la explanada de la mezquita y genera todo lo que significa después la segunda intifada. Hoy en día, a diario, ingresan militares judíos con turistas judíos a la explanada de la mezquita, cosa que dentro de la Torá no está permitido que entre cualquier judío a la explanada. ¿Cómo ven ellos que esto podría terminar este constante violación tanto religiosa como política? en Palestina.
There's three questions. What's your perspective about the Talmud and the way they demonize Judaism? And what's your perspective of this Zionist movement in the south of Chile, which is called Plan Andina, if you are aware of that movement where they're buying lands of Chile? And the second person says, what's your perspective of how military and Jews are going into mosques, and this is against the Torah, and yeah. And how will this finish religiously and politically?
Yeah, with the help of the Almighty. First of all, Zionism causes that the Talmud gets this terrible rap, that people look at it very badly, and not only Talmud, but Judaism altogether gets a bad rap. People look at it badly because of the actions of Zionism.
Debido a las acciones del sionismo, el judaísmo se está viendo muy afectado y se ve lo miran muy mal.
The Talmud is basically when God gave the Torah to Moses on Mount Sinai. It is 613 commandments, very complicated, and orally God spoke to Moses, and this was written in the form of the Talmud, the explanation of all the laws.
Moses,
Moshe Rabbeinu, the leader of Jews, went up to Mount Sinai. Took the Torah from God, but it's not comprehensible without the Talmud.
No es comprensible sin el Talmud.
So, but the Talmud was expanded. It's written in like about 20 volumes. It's very large.
Pero es muy, muy amplio.
Where the rabbis discuss, expand on each law, explain it in very detail.
Para que cada rabino lo explique detalladamente.
And there's many words of rebuke to the Jewish people, explains the prophecies and much.
Y hay muchas profecías.
And so, for instance, it says the Jews are because they don't go to the Holy Land, because they're living in exile. It's like they're serving idol worship. They're idol worshippers. They're like they're serving an idol.
Están sirviendo a un ídolo.
Yet the Talmud was written in Babylon.
Sin embargo, el Talmud fue escrito en Babilonia.
So it's to understand the Talmud, you must really study it properly.
Se debe estudiar apropiadamente.
I can only say that history, you can see, where we had very religious communities and we lived in
solo puedo decir
many
que a través
lands.
De la historia hemos vivido en muchas comunidades religiosas y en muchas tierras.
And we practiced and lived and breathed by the Talmud.
Y practicamos y respiramos por el Talmud.
Because you can't be a religious Jew without it.
Porque no puedes ser un religioso judío sin él.
And we were considered holy people, we were respected. And we lived in total harmony with our Arab neighbors and other neighbors and other countries.
Personas respetuosas y vivíamos en paz con nuestros vecinos árabes.
So you can see that it's being misconstrued, the words of the Talmud, because it's impossible to be bad. And if you see the living examples of people who follow the Talmud, that it is good, it's not a bad thing.
Y si ves el ejemplo vivo de las personas que siguen al pie de la letra del Talmud, no es algo malo.
It's only Zionism. They take
sionismo.
Out verses to commit their evil.
Es solo sionismo que saca versos desde ciertas cosas para cometer su maldad.
Now about the other issue of Plan Andina, I know that for instance the Zionists, they really don't. They're not religious. They don't care for Israel. They only went to Palestine because they believed they will get support from the Christians, from the world, because they'll say God gave it to us.
En cuanto a la otra pregunta, no son personas, las personas que llegan, no son personas realmente judías, sino que llegan por un objetivo.
One of the plans was to go to Patagonia and buy a plan. They did that. They started buying over there.
Un plan era ir a la Patagonia.
But as a Jew,
Pero como judío,
who is true to the religion,
que es verdadera hacia la religión,
we are forbidden to have any Jewish sovereignty anywhere on this planet Earth.
Tenemos prohibido tener cualquier tipo de soberanía en este planeta.
It's never acceptable.
No es aceptable.
Now, as individuals, if they're accepted Jews in any country, we thank the leadership in countries that, like Chile or wherever, that takes us up as citizens. We are very thankful, and
somos
we as a United States citizen.
Somos agradecidos de países que nos acogen y que nos dan la ciudadanía, etcétera.
And we pray for it's the well-being of the that they should have a long life. They should be healthy and prosperous, the country and the leaders.
Y claro, deben ser ciudadanos obedientes.
Now about the mosque. It's very ironic because the Zionists keep on talking about it's theirs.
Los sionistas siguen diciendo que es de su propiedad.
Since 2,000 years ago, since the destruction of the temple,
desde la destrucción del templo hace 2,000 años atrás,
a religious Jew knows we are forbidden to go into the area of the whole area where the temple was in the temple mount.
Un judío religioso sabe que tenemos prohibido entrar a cualquier templo religioso.
It's considered one of the most cardinal and biggest crimes against God.
Es considerado uno de los crímenes más terribles en contra de Dios.
It's one of the worst punishments in the Torah is kares, that we're cut off from God. If somebody goes onto the Temple Mount today, and because we're not in the right purity, we're considered cut off from God.
Debido a que no tenemos el nivel de purificación o el nivel de espiritualidad adecuado, entrar a un lugar sagrado como eso significa ser sacado de la gracia de Dios.
Yet the Prime Minister Sharon, just
embargo,
to make a political statement, took 1,000 soldiers and walked onto the mount. Just
embargo,
to give you an example.
Sin embargo, para hacer una manifestación política, el primer ministro llevó un montón de soldados a entrar a las mezquitas, solamente para hacer un
I think that's a perfect example of the difference between Judaism and Zionism. Yeah. Tengo una
pregunta de acá.
Si bien hay poca información todavía sobre la diferencia entre el sionismo y el judaísmo, cada vez aquí en Chile al menos se empiezan a ver más manifestantes a favor de la posición palestina y que empiezan a informarse también sobre la posición de ustedes.
You can see that Chile is one of the countries that shows more support for the Palestinian people and is more informed.
Pero esto de todas formas no es algo institucionalizado.
But this is not organized or institutionalized.
Porque nuestro país sigue siendo un país entre comillas aliado de Estados Unidos y aliado de Israel como Estado sionista.
Because our country is an ally of the United States and of Israel.
Mi pregunta concisa es: ¿existen países que como gobierno estén a favor del movimiento judío propiamente tal?
A favor del movimiento
judío religioso.
Is there any other country that you know that is in favor of the religious Jews that are anti-Zionist, like clearly anti-Zionist around the world?
Do you have any ally?
Don't make me cry. What can I say? You know, I mean, Islamic Republic of Iran.
Iran.
What can I say? Maybe Lebanon. Maybe Yemen was. We used to be very close with Yemen. We used to go there every year to help the Jewish communities.
Con
there.
Yemen era muy cercano.
You know, but like you know, the politics. Is in our teachings it says that be careful from a politician because everything they do, I'd be very careful what I say, is for their own good.
Y ellos como su religión siempre tienen la advertencia de no tratar mucho con políticos porque cualquier cosa que ellos hagan lo van a hacer a su propia conveniencia.
It's very hard for a political power that they have to deal with other countries and this and so I'm not blaming people, we only
No culpamos a nadie, sino que simplemente esperamos.
We only hope that there will be, you know, that the God will put in the minds of these leaders that they should change their approach.
De que Dios va a ayudar a que estos líderes políticos cambien su visión acerca del Estado de Israel. Mm-hmm.
pregunta de ella.
Sí, lo primero es agradecer su visita, felicitarlo y sobre todo por su valentía al defender una causa justa como la causa de la verdad.
Thank you for your courage and for being here.
Thank you, and thank you again. Took so much time.
Gracias a ustedes por su tiempo.
Y quería hacer la pregunta, una reflexión.
Thinking something he was thinking.
Noam Finkelstein, autor judío, publicó un libro que se llama El negocio del Holocausto.
The business of Holocaust.
Y plantea que es económicamente rentable e ideológicamente conveniente para el Estado de Israel.
¿Quién escribió ese libro?
Noam Finkelstein.
Noam Finkelstein. He wrote a book about the business about the Holocaust.
Yes. Otros autores judíos, como David Cole, como Joseph Burg y otros que han apoyado investigación sobre el Holocausto, convienen que ha sido un negocio que favorece ideológicamente el Estado sionista.
They all say it was something planned that helps the ideology of the Zionists.
Pero además, ahí se sabe por la prensa, investigaciones, medios libres, de que hay negocios como el tráfico de órganos, de diamantes, etcétera, y fundamentalmente el comercio de armas. El estado de guerra contra el mundo árabe, el estado de guerra en que vive el estado sionista, estimula, porque lo justifica, el desarrollo armamentista. Y eso es un tremendo negocio. La reflexión es en torno a si quizás una élite económica ideológica está haciendo los negocios que no podría hacer de otra manera a través de un estado como es el Estado sionista.
Well, his reflection goes towards the state of Israel, which is basically financed by wars.
Yeah.
You know, and there's a bunch of investigations that come up about organ traffics. And weapon traffic too. So the state of war is this basically financing this this state. But ¿qué es lo que dijiste tú de la élite?
Hay una élite, al parecer una élite ideológica y económica está haciendo negocios que no podría ser de otra manera.
There's this certain type of elite that is doing this way of business that can't, don't know how to do any other type of business.
Well, the point is that we know that there's many reasons it could be. I was saying, even if it would be the best, because people do it for their feelings of suffering for the Jews, even on the best case scenario,
y aunque fuera en el mejor escenario,
it's still wrong, patently wrong. The state of Israel should not exist.
El Estado de Israel no debería existir.
Even if it wouldn't be because of other interests, I'm saying, you know, that because of the well-meaning people who support it, it's wrong. That's what I'm here for, to say, forget about you want to have this theory, that theory. I'm talking straight on the best case scenario. It can't be. It's patently illegitimate.
Solamente quiero dejar en claro que el Estado de Israel es completamente ilegítimo, aunque fuera en el mejor de los casos.
I want everybody to acknowledge. I acknowledge two people here who are giving their hearts and souls. I have, of course, Nicole, who's, I don't know if you know how much effort he's doing for Palestine. I know many, many years.
Quiero reconocer el trabajo de Nicola Jaguas, que durante años ha estado luchando por la causa palestina.
God bless him and protect him.
Que Dios lo bendiga.
Yeah, and the whole family. And then, of course, now we have Maureen here, who's, if you look at her and see how what she's going through, and she's coming and helping along. It's really, we have to acknowledge. God should bless and thank you very much.
No,
queremos agradecerles a todos ustedes la asistencia. Tenemos material en español que han traído los rabinos y que les vamos a hacer la entrega a cada uno de ustedes. Y agradecer en especial a la Unión Nacional Estudiantil, quienes nos han facilitado este espacio, quienes además defendieron el derecho a usar el... Ya tuvimos la mala experiencia ayer en la Universidad de Santiago, que nos cancelaron a última hora la posibilidad de exponer en esta universidad. Por lo tanto, agradecemos también que la Católica no haya cedido, que no haya cedido las presiones que recibimos de parte de la comunidad sionista en Chile, que me presionó muy fuerte para que no nos prestaran este espacio. Así que en ese sentido, los agradecimientos también van a la Universidad Católica, que nos posibilitaron también que esté en esta sala y a las gestiones realizadas por la Unión Nacional Estudiantil. Así que, bueno, para terminar, un aplauso grande a los alumnos. Pueden revisar igual nuestra página compañifila.cl, nuestro Facebook y Twitter, donde vamos a estar con más actividades. Mañana en Santiago, un encuentro con la comunidad palestina abierto a todos en el Estadio Palestino, en la Avenida Kennedy, en Las Condes. Igual, obviamente, pueden pasar el dato, invitar a sus amigos de allá para que asistan.
¿Qué hora es la página?
A las 7:30 en el Facebook está toda la información. Nos pueden encontrar y preguntar. O la página, con Palestina. Muchas gracias por asistir. Si tienen dudas o